Hacienda, Rabbit here. Today we're going to make something great from Miami, Florida, Little Havana. We're making Cuban food. We are going to make mojo puerco, or pernil, which is a Cuban-style roasted pork butt. And it is the star of this movie, Chef. For those of you who have never seen this movie, it is a foodies movie. You need to see it. It's one of my all-time favorite movies of ever. And it's got an all-star cast. It's just a great movie. Everybody lives happily ever after at the end. And the beauty about this movie is the mojo pork is the star of the movie. It is awesome. The cast, Scarlett Johansson, John Leguizamo, one of the best comedians ever to come out of the 2000s or the 21st century. Sofia Vergara, Robert Downey Jr., Dustin Hoffman, yes, he's in there too. Oliver Platt, Russell Peters, another great comedian. If you don't know Russell Peters, you've got to check him out on YouTube. He's a second generation Indian. His parents were from India. Emigrated to Canada, where he was born. And so his comedy is just Indian, Western, Canadian. It is just spot on. No profanity, just clean, funny stuff. You're gonna love it. So also Aaron Franklin. Hey, Aaron Franklin is a barbecue king, right? He's in there too. And a cast of others. Anyway, John Fabreau, who plays Casper something or other, he's the chef, the star, loses his job at the restaurant and starts a food truck. That's essentially Chef for Dummies. Anyway, to build this movie, they had to get a professional chef to help. And so they got this guy called Roy Choy, who busted into fame in the early 2000s with Korean-Mexican fusion in LA. And he has a fleet of trucks, world famous, probably has a Michelin star, I think. Anyway, so he was the professional consultant for the movie. And this is his recipe, Roy Choi's recipe in this movie. Now, what I'm showing you is the soundtrack CD. The DVD is not available, okay? You've got to get it streaming. Last time I saw it, I got it free from Amazon Prime, okay? So you can find it anywhere. And I highly recommend you watching that movie. It is amazing. The food alone is worth the ticket. Okay, so it's got great music, by the way, and you'll hear some of it throughout the video. So I've been wanting to try this guy's recipe for years now, and I'm gonna do it. So come on, let's go. What we got here is the sampling of the ingredients that are going into the marinade, because this is a two-day effort. We got ourselves a 10.5-pound bone-in pork butt. We got some oregano and cumin, cilantro, mint. We got many oranges and many limes, and we got buttloads of garlic over here. Real garlic, not cheater's garlic. And yeah, let's go ahead and get everything set up and get the marinade going.
Si do, re, do, si, la, sol, si, la. Si, si, hipócrita ya. Cuenta las cosas atrás. Tú y tú debes de aprender. Tú y tú debes cada cual. Piensa así, comprende que sí. Cada cual tiene su bimbi. Yo nací con mi bim bim y tengo mi bom bom bom, que se sepa, la 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 la. Yo nací con mi bim bim.
nací con mi bim bim y tengo mi bom bom bom.
Oye, tengo mi bim bim bim, también tengo mi bom bom bom. Vengo
solo. Mi bim bim y tengo mi bom bom bom.
Mi bancito goza la rumba cuando repica el tambor.
Yo nací con mi bim bim y tengo mi bom bom.
Hello and welcome back. Through the miracle of time, it is now tomorrow. Yeah, it's Sunday. So now we have the Mojo Pork, which I have drained out of all its marinade. You got to discard that. It's no use for that. So now it is absolutely delicious. Take a look at that. Oh, yeah. So we've got preheated oven to 425 degrees. We're going to shove that baby in there for half an hour. Join me then. Okay, after half an hour at 425 Fahrenheit in the oven, we're going to baste it with some olive oil, like that. And we're lowering the oven to 375 degrees, where we're going to cook it for about 2 hours or so. I'll tell you the actual temperature because we want to get it up to 160, 65 degrees. So join me then. 2.5 hours in. Let's go. Oh, doesn't that look good? Temping at 160, 165. That's delicious. Let's slice it up and taste it. Man, this baby is smelling so good. And look at this. Crispy fat, deliciousness. Let's turn this around so you can see this beauty. Man, this kitchen is smelling awesome. Oh. Oh, yes. Man, the scene in the movie Chef where John Leguizamo roasts the first pork so they can make the pingao sandwiches. That's beautiful. This is what it looks like. Let's taste it. Okay, here we go. Oh, oh, that is so tender. Oof. Oof. My goodness gracious. Oh, yes. Okay, let's try it. Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah, people. It's all that. Wow. Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. Mm. Got a piece of that crispy skin. Wow. Mm. Oh man. Oh man. This is deliciousness. Okay, so. Wow. I gotta cut some more. Look at that. Steaming lowliness. So easy to cut. 165. If you want to make it pullable, keep cooking. You can't ruin this. Cook it to 185, it'll pull. But we wanted it sliceable. Why? Because next video, that'll come out next week, I'm going to make cubanos sandwiches, el pingao, just like the movie Chef. I'm going to make them later today, but you're going to see them next week. So stay tuned and join me then. Thanks for watching, people. Y'all take care.